honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Chandrababu Naidu Garu, Honorable Finance Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Yanamala Garu, Honorable Chief Minister Pudisseri V. Narayana Swamy, Deputy Chief Minister of Delhi, Manish Sisodia, Minister of Finance, West Bengal, Dr. Amit Mitra, Minister of Finance, Punjab, Manpreet Singh, and Peace Team Express, other dignitaries present here. During the last 1 month, I think we have traveled a long way. To start with, we have succeeded in raising the issues related to terms of reference at a national level, national debate. Oh, whatever be the reason, after the terms of reference were published, there has been only one academic article. That's by Mr. Bhaskar. There was a silence. You must have spoken, but I have.
Three articles,
okay. But now things have reached a stage where the Honorable Prime Minister is forced to respond. Honorable Union Finance Minister has also responded. And a real debate has started. And the issues have also been widened. Initially, it was considered to be North versus South and population base here and so on. But now everybody agrees that there are more even graver issues of fiscal federalism that are going to be examined. And finally, we were just four states when we met in Trivandrum. Now already we are six. And Karnataka was supposed to come, Mizoram also, for whatever reasons they couldn't make it. But I'm certain it will be minimum 10 when we reach Delhi. That was this year, minimum 10. And then I think we will call upon other states who, though agree in private, like, for example, Tamil Nadu or even Telangana, private they agree with, but for whatever reason don't come. And other states who may have different opinion, let's have a debate on this. So we shall move on. Now, since we are all agreed about the issues, there is a danger of repetition. Thus far, I intend to be very brief. During the discussion so far, we have identified three sets of issues related to vertical devolution and one with respect to horizontal devolution and some general points. Now, vertical devolution, there is a real danger of tax share of states being reduced from 42% downwards. That's what explicitly TOR asked the Commission to do, which strength. And when everybody understands this 32% and 42% are not really strictly comparable, the TOR especially goes to problems, financial problems created to center because of the increase in the share of taxes to states. So it's only like a pretending the issue. So, secondly, in the para 5, there is a reference to doing it with the revenue deficit grant. And the way it is stated is in a very cavalier fashion, where it should be continued at all. That's the way it is put, right? And general tenor, take the case of GST for example. It's a revenue neutral tax, that's supposed to be. And not only that, if a compensation is paid from a compensation says, then the revenues are not affected. But that's made out to be a big issue, how GST would impact upon the central government funds and so on. So whole tenor of the TOR is that share of state should be reduced. Now, the second one is regarding borrowing powers of the state. This is also very, very important. So you have a whole para regarding the fiscal consolidation. And again, the Finance Commission to tread the path of stringent conditionalities. Maybe you want the review of the Fiscal Responsible Budget Management Act Review Committee suggested, which would mean a terrible loss to the states. Borrowing power is going to be reduced to 1.7. Worst, so far there has been no conditionalities on borrowing, other than the fiscal deficit ceiling of 3%. Now, they are exploring the possibilities of putting conditionalities on borrowing. So it's a very, very dangerous one. And thirdly, they were trying to roll back the achievements or the positive position taken by the 14th Finance Commission in terms of state-specific grants or incentive grants for various things, which has been reduced to the minimum. Now we have a long litany of lists, mostly relating to central government expenditure, which is supposed to be incentivized and so on. So very retrograde still. So these are the issues related to vertical development. And the interstate distribution of revenues between the states, the population base here. Only when that happened was the Prime Minister telling Tamil Nadu they won't be affected because the incentivization clause for states which have succeeded in reducing the fertility. Forgetting the simple fact, 90%, 91% of the revenue devolution would take place on the base of 2011 population, tax devolution. And at best, this particular incentive can have a less than share of 2%. So in what way it is going to compensate for the loss that will take place because shift in population base here is nobody can say. This has raised public, but nobody, neither even a finance minister or prime minister responded to that. And finally, the totally undemocratic tenor, the Honorable Chief Minister Puducherry put it very well, the populist measures to be determined by a commission. So these are the issues that we have identified. And well, now, I think today we must devote much of our time to fine-tune the memorandum draft which has been prepared. Already a major suggestions have come regarding the treatment of unit territory and the Finance Commission, which I fully support the position already taken. Maybe there will be other things, the language editing, fine-tuning, etc. Maybe for the consideration of the Honorable President, like in Trivandrum, we'll compress both the second session and third session together, get into the actual work on the memorandum so that we spend substantial time, because as I told you, since we are in broad agreement, we'll be meeting only